Hey there, how's it going everybody? In this video, we're going to be continuing to work on our user profile page and add the ability to upload a profile picture for our users. So we'll do this by extending the user model that we currently have to add more fields. And we'll also learn how to use Django signals to run specific functions after certain actions, which can be extremely useful for this type of work. So let's go ahead and get started. So first of all, by default, the default users model that Django provides for us doesn't have a field for a profile picture. So how can we add that? So in order to do that, we're going to have to extend the user model and create a new profile model that has a one-to-one relationship with the user. So a one-to-one relationship means that one user can have one profile and one profile will be associated with one user. So let's go ahead and add this so that our users can have profile pictures. So this will be a new model in our users app. And when we created this app, it created a models.py file for us. So let's open that up. So I've already got that open up here on my machine. So this is the models.py file located inside of your user's app. And we can see that this is currently empty. Now we've worked with models a little bit when we created our post model in the blog app in an earlier video. Okay, so first of all, we'll be extending the existing user model that Django provides for us. So we need to import that. So we can do that up here at the top just by saying from django.contrib.auth.models import user. And now let's create our new model. And I will call this profile. So I'll say class profile. And we want to inherit from models.model. And now we want to create that one-to-one relationship with the existing user model. So to do that, we can say user is equal to, and this will be the user for this profile, models.1to1 field. Make sure you get the capitalization right in there. So now we want this to have a one-to-one relationship with the user model. So we will pass that in there. And also we want to specify an onDelete argument. So the onDelete argument tells Django what we want to do with the profile if the user is deleted. So we'll say on_delete is equal to, and that will be models.cascade. Now we saw this in the post model in a previous video, but just a recap, cascade means that if the user is deleted, then also delete the profile. But if we delete the profile, then it won't delete the user. So it's just a one-way thing. And that makes sense. So in this case, if we ever delete a user from a database, then there's no reason in keeping around their profile with their images and all that stuff either. So that will just be deleted with the user. Okay, so now that we have a user associated with this profile, now we can add any additional fields that we want. Now you could add other fields here if you like you could add a bio or a current city or whatever it is you want, but I'm just going to add a profile picture. So I'm just going to call this image, and this will be an image field. So we'll say image is equal to models.image field. And now we'll pass in a couple of arguments here. So I'll say default is equal to, this will be default.jpg. So that'll be a default image for any user. And now we can also add in upload to is equal to, and we'll set this equal to profile_pics. So that'll just be the directory that images get uploaded to when we upload a profile. Okay, so that small change should give us user profiles for each of our users. So now let's create a dunder str method so that when we print this out, it'll display how we want it to be displayed. So if you don't know what that is, we talked about it briefly in another video, but basically if we don't have a dunder str method, then anytime we print out a profile, then it's just going to say profile object, and we want it to be more descriptive than that. So if we want it to be more specific, then we need to tell it exactly how we want it to print it out. So let's put this in here. So I'll say def dunder dunder str, and this takes self as an argument, which is the instance. And now we want to return how we want this to be displayed. So I'll return an f string here, and within the f string, I will use the self.user.username. And then after that, I will print out profile. So let's say we have that CoreyMS user here. Then whenever we print out their profile, it will print out the username, which is CoreyMS, and then profile. So it'll say CoreyMS profile. Okay, so now that we've added this model, Remember that anytime we make a change to our models, this is also going to make a change to the database, but it hasn't made any changes yet. We still need to run our migrations for those changes to take effect. And that's also the great thing about migrations, because we can make database changes like this over time. Okay, so let's bring up our terminal and run these migrations. So I'm going to bring up my terminal here, and I'm currently in my project directory where my manage.py file is located. So remember, we can create migrations for our changes just by saying Python manage.py make migrations. So right now, if we run this, then we can see that we get an error, and it says that we cannot use image field because Pillow is not installed. And then it gives us a hint here that says that we can solve this, but just by running pip install Pillow. Now, if you don't know what Pillow is, it's a library for working with images within Python. So that's, we kind of need that for our image field. So let's just go ahead and install that. So with pip, we can just say pip install Pillow, just like it told us to. If we run that, then it will install that. And with that installed, let's try to run our make migrations command again. So I'm going to clear my screen, hit up a couple of times, and then rerun that make migrations. Okay, so that worked, and we can see that it created a new migration file for us in our users migration directory. So remember from the database video where we did this before, that just creates the migrations, but we haven't actually run the migrations to update the database yet. So we can actually do that with the migrate command. So I'll say Python manage.py migrate. Okay, so that should have applied the changes to the database. So now I want to be able to view these user profiles on the admin page of our website so that we can see what this looks like. But if I want to do this, then we have to remember that we need to register this model within the admin file of our app. And this is an easy step to forget, and I do it all the time. So let's just go ahead and do that right now. So if we go back to our project within our user's app, we have this admin.py file, and if we click on that, then it's already importing admin for us, and it says to register your models here, and we want to register that profile model that we just created. So first we have to import that, so we'll say from.models import profile, and then we will register that. So we'll say admin.site.register and pass in that profile model and save that. Okay, so now that we have that registered with our admin page, let's run our development server and log in and try to add a profile picture for one of our users. So we will pull up the terminal here and run our development server. So I'll say Python manage.py run server, then pull up our website. And now let's go to the login page. So I'll go to let's go to the admin page. So I'll go to /admin. And let me make this a little larger here so everyone can see. Okay, so here on the admin page, we can see that we have a section down here for profiles. So if I click on profiles, then we can see that it says that there are currently zero profiles. So the users that we've already created don't have profiles yet. And we'll set this up in a bit so that when we create users, it also creates a profile for that user. But for now, let's just create one manually. So over here to the top right, I can click on add profile. And let's create a profile for this Corey MS user. And I will add an image here. So I'll just go to my desktop where I have a few. And I'm just going to click on this pick here and upload that and then save. Okay, so now we can see that we have a Corey MS profile here. And let's also create another user profile for a user and not provide them with an image. And that way it'll use the default. So I'm just going to go up here to add profile again. And let's do this one for this test user, and we won't upload an image. We'll just let it use the default. So then we'll save. And now we can see that we have another profile where we didn't actually upload an image. So now let me show you how we can access these profiles and images on our site. So to demonstrate this, I'm going to stop our dev server for a second and run the Django shell so that we can look at a user profile interactively. So let me pull up the Django shell here. So I'm going to stop the dev server and let's run that by saying Python manage.py and then shell. Okay, so first I'm going to import the built-in Django user model, and we've seen this before. So this is in django.contrib.auth.models import user. And now let me grab the user for the username of Corey MS. So I can say user is equal to, user.objects.filter. Then we can filter that by a username equal to Corey MS, and you can change that for whatever user you are using. And then I will just grab the first result from there. So we can see that we have that user. Okay, so now that we created a profile for this user, then now it has a one-to-one relationship with the profile. So we can actually access the profile associated with this user directly from the user. So we could just say user.profile. And we can see that it says that it's this profile object of CoreyMS profile. And so if we wanted to access this user's image, then we could just string that together even further. So we could say user.profile.image. And we can see there we got an image field file, and it is in profile pics, pic.jpg. And let me clear the screen here so we have a little bit more space, and I will rerun that last command. And now we also have a lot of different attributes that we can access through this image. So let's say that we wanted to see the width of the image. We can do image.width. We can see that's 1500 pixels. And we could also do that for the height and the size of the image as well. Now on our website, we won't be accessing the image directly, but we'll be using the location of the image. So if you're familiar with HTML, then how you do images is you pass in the image location into the source attribute of an image tag in order to display it in the browser. So in order to just get the location of the image, we can use the URL attribute. So I'll say user.profile.image.url. And so that gives us the location of the image. Now, you might be wondering, if I was to upload another picture with the file name of pic.jpg, then will it just overwrite this one? And it actually wouldn't. It would instead just tag on a hash value onto the file name to make sure that duplicate names don't overwrite each other. Okay, so let's also look at the profile for the user where we didn't upload an image. So that user's username was test user. So I'm going to hit up a couple of times until I get back to my query. And instead of searching for CoreyMS, I'm going to search for test user. And if I look at that, then I do have that user. So I'm going to clear the screen here. And now let's look at his profile image. So if I say user.profile.image, then we can see that he has a image of default.jpg. And we haven't uploaded a default image onto our site to use for users without a picture yet, but we will do that soon. Okay, so now let me exit out of this shell and start our development server again. So I'll exit out of this and start the development server again by doing python manage.py run server. Okay, so now let's go back to our project and see where this image was actually saved. So if we look in our Django project, then we should now see a directory in our project called profile pics. So I know this is a little small in the sidebar here, but I have a profile pics here within my Django project, and this lives in the same directory as our apps. So we have blog, Django project, users, and profile pics. So that profile pics directory is located in the same place that our manage.py file is located. And that is the name that we passed into the upload to parameter of the image field in our profile model. So that's why it has the name profile pics. Now, I don't actually think that this is a good location for these pictures, because if multiple users or if multiple models were all saving different kinds of images, then they'd clutter up our project's root directory with different image directories. So let's change some settings so that we can change the location of where these images are actually saved. And we need to also change a couple of different settings so that our website can find these images when we try to view them from within the browser. So let's do this by opening up our project's settings.py file. And within our settings, we're going to need to define something called media root and media URL. So let me go down to the bottom and I'll put these right underneath our static URL setting here. So I will set media root and set this equal to just blank for now. I'll also create media URL and set this to blank for now. So the media root is going to be the full path to a directory where we'd like Django to store uploaded files. So for performance reasons, these files are stored on the file system and not in the database. So this media root is the directory where the uploaded files will be saved. So let's still keep this in the base directory of our project, but we'll put it in a directory called media. So we can specify a full path just by saying, so we already have the OS module imported. So we can say os.path.join, and we will join the base underscore dir with a string of media. Okay, so what we're doing here is using the os.path.join method, we'll make sure that the full path to that directory is created correctly no matter what operating system you're on. And the base dir variable here is a variable that Django created at the top of our settings file that specifies the location of the project's base directory. So basically, this is just saying that the media root will be at our project's base directory and then have a directory in there called media. Okay, so now let's set the media URL. And the media URL is the public URL of that directory. So basically, this is how we will access our media through the browser. So I'm just going to set this equal to /media. Okay, so just in case that's confusing, let me go over these one more time. So the media root is where our uploaded files will be located on the file system. So for example, remember in our profile model that we said that we wanted our images to be uploaded to a directory called profile pics. So with this media root set to this directory called media, then now when we upload an image, it will create a profile pics directory inside of this media directory and put the image in there. And that media directory will be located at the base directory of our project. And the media URL is how we're going to access that image in the browser. So it'll be at /media/profile pics, and then the name of that image. And we'll see exactly what this looks like in just a second. Okay, so with those changes that we just made, those actually won't be applied to the profiles that we've already created. So we need to go in and remove those two profiles that we created and then recreate those to get these changes to take effect. So let me pull up our admin page here and reload this. And now let's just delete these two profiles that we created. So I will select delete selected profiles, delete both of those. Yes, I'm sure. And now let me add a profile for CoreMS, and I will upload that same picture and save that. Now create another profile, and we'll do this one for test user, and we just won't select an image. So I will save that. Okay, so with that done, if we go back to our project here, then now we should see a media folder inside the base directory of our project. And if we look inside the media folder, then we can see a profile pics directory, and inside of there, we can see a pic.jpg. Now the old profile pics directory is still in our project base directory from before, and that won't be used anymore. So you can just delete that. So I'm just going to delete that here within Sublime Text and delete that old profile pics within the base directory of our project. So just so you can see this a little better, let me open this actually in my Finder so that we can see this. So this is the base directory of our project, and we can see that we have our blog app, our users app, and our Django project, but then we also have this media directory here. Within media, we have profile pics. Within profile pics, we have the profile picture that we uploaded. Okay, so now let's see how we can display all of this in our profile page that we created in the last video. So if I open up the template for that page, so that is within users, templates, and then the user's subdirectory there, and then that is in profile.html. Now within our current profile page, all we have is the user's username being printed out, but we want this profile page to have their username, profile picture, email address, and also the ability to update this information. So just to get us started off, let's grab a snippet from some of my code snippets so that you don't have to see me type all of this out. And again, I have a link to these snippets in the description section below, so you can copy and paste to follow along. So I'm going to open up my snippets directory, and I have a file here called profile.html. So I'm going to open that in Sublime, and I'm going to copy all of this HTML here, And this is what I want to paste into the content block of our profile template. So back in our profile template, I'm going to overwrite our H1 tag here and just paste in that snippet from that profile.html snippet. And this HTML snippet that we copied here is just a short little layout that has some Bootstrap classes to make things look a little nicer, plus some styles from the main.css file that we added earlier in our base template. Okay, so within my snippet here, I have a placeholder for the username and the email. So let's change those to the current user's username and email. So right here where it says username, we will instead access a variable and say user.username. And instead of this dummy email here, we will access a variable and say user.email. Now, I also have an image here for the user's profile picture. And right now, the source for this picture is just hard-coded in. But we want this to be set to the user's image if they've uploaded one. And if they haven't uploaded one, then it will just be that default.jpg. So let's update the hard-coded source here within the template to be equal to the location of the user's image. So we saw how to do this earlier in the Python shell. So we can just access an attribute and we can say user.profile.image. Let me scroll over a little bit here so we can see. .image.url. And that should provide the correct location to the image. But there is still one more thing that we need to do in order to get this to work. So we still need to add those media routes to our URL patterns. Now, there are different ways to do this in development and production. So let me pull up the Django documentation so that we can see what they say about this. So in my browser here, I have the Django documentation pulled up to the managing static files documentation. Then let me make this a little bit larger here so that others can see. So we can see that it says serving files uploaded by a user during development. During development, you can serve user uploaded media files from the media root. This is not suitable for production use. For some common deployment strategies, see deploying static files. So when we actually deploy this site, we're going to have to read through the documentation on deploying static files. But now, since we're only in development, this is how we're going to do this. So it says, for example, if your media URL is defined as media, then you can do this by adding the following snippet to your project's urls.py file. And we can see here that they are importing the settings and importing static, and then just adding this on to our URL patterns. Now I'm going to take their code block that they suggested here, and I'm going to alter it just slightly. So I'm going to copy what they suggest putting into our urls.py file. And now let's open up urls.py from our project. So within our project, we are going to open urls.py, scroll down here a little bit. And now let me paste in what I got from their website. So this is what it said to do in their website. So it said to import the settings and import static using these lines here. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. So I will copy those and I'll move them up here towards the top and save that. Now we also have our URL patterns here. And it says just to add the static media URL here onto the end. Now, I'm pretty sure that they check the debug settings for you if you were to add this on, but I kind of like to be a little bit more explicit. So instead, I'm just going to actually say that if our settings, and settings is something that we imported up here. So if settings.debug, which means if we are currently in debug mode, then we want to add these to our URL patterns. So I will just cut that out from there. And then say URL patterns plus equals this static section here that we got from the documentation. I just like doing it this way instead of adding it directly to our URL patterns up here, because if anybody else is reading our code, then it's a little bit more understandable what this is doing, that we're only adding this on when we're in debug mode. Okay, so now with our media URL and our media root added to our URL patterns, now this should now allow our media to work within the browser. So let's open this up and go to our profile page. So we have all of this saved. And if we look at our dev server is still running, so there's no errors there. That's good. And now let's open up our page. So I'll go back to view site here. Let me resize this. And now let's go to our profile page for our current logged in user. So we can see now that we have a little profile section here that has the image that we uploaded. It also has the user's username and the user's email. Okay, so there are two more things that I'd like to finish up in this video. So first of all, we haven't actually uploaded a default image for our users yet. So if I log out of our current user and then log in as our test user, so let me log in with that test user's credentials. If we go to their profile page, then we can see that they have the default profile image, but we haven't actually uploaded a default image yet. So if I look at where this is looking for this image, if I right click on this and say open image in new tab, then it's looking in /media/default.jpg. So in order to get that to work, all we need to do is drop an image in there that we want to use as the default image for users who haven't set their profile picture. So I have a file on my desktop that I'm going to use. And again, I'll have all of these files available in the snippets linked in the description section below. So I'm going to open this folder and drop it into that media folder in our project. So let's open this. So we have our snippets open here. I need to go back to my desktop. So this is my desktop here. I'm going to use this image as the default. And now let me open our Django project. So this is our Django project here. And here we have our media folder. So I'm going to open that media folder and we can see that we have our profile pics directory there. Now our default.jpg, I'm just going to paste right in our media folder. So once we have that pasted into our media folder, if we go back to the browser and reload this page, then now it can see that default.jpg image. Okay, so now that we have that working, there's one more thing that I want to do before finishing up this video. So right now we have a pretty nice user system where users have these profile pages and profile pictures, but we'll want to make sure that for every new user that is created, they automatically get a profile as well, which would include the default profile picture. Because the way that this is set up right now, we actually have to go into the admin page and create the profiles for each of our users. And we don't want to do that every time. So this is fairly easy to do. So what we need to do here is to add something called a Django signal. And we're going to create a new file in our users app called signals where we can write this. So let me open back up our project here in our editor and let me close down some of the files that we have previously been working with since this is getting a little cluttered here. So now in our users app, we're going to create a file inside our users app and we're going to call this signals.py. Now you'll see some people put these signals in the models.py file where we created the profile model, but the Django documentation recommends doing it this way to avoid some side effects of how imports work. So we're going to import a signal called post save. So within the signals.py file, we can say from Django, let me spell that right, from django.db.models.signals, we want to import post_save. Now this is a signal that gets fired after an object is saved. So in this case, we want to get a post save signal when a user is created. So we're also going to need to import the built-in user model as well. So we've seen this before. This is from django.contrib.auth.models import user. And the user model here is going to be what we call the sender, since it is going to be what is sending the signal. And we're also going to need to create a receiver. A receiver is going to be a function that gets this signal and then performs some task. So we need to also import the receiver. So I'll say from Django.dispatch import receiver and save that. Now in these long imports here, it's always easy to make some spelling mistakes. So double check that and make sure that you are good to go there. Okay, and finally, we want to import profile from our models since we'll be creating a profile in our function. So we'll say from.models import profile and save that. Okay, so now that we have all of these things imported, we can tie them all together. So the reason that we're doing this is because we want a user profile to be created for each new user. So let's write a function called create profile. So I'll say def create underscore profile. And this is going to take a few different parameters here. So we will have a sender, and we will have an instance. We will have created, and also we will have this ** quarks. And now within this function, we'll just say if created, then we want profile.objects.create, and we want to create a user equal to instance. Okay, so now we have a create profile function that we want to run every time a user is created, but we haven't actually tied that functionality together yet. So to do this, we're going to use that receiver that we imported, and receiver is going to be a decorator that we can add to our function. So up here at the top, we'll say at receiver. And this decorator takes some arguments. It takes the signal that we want, which is post underscore save, and also the sender. So we'll say sender is equal to user. Okay, so I know that this looks confusing, but we can think of it all together like this. So we can see that we have a sender here and then a signal of post save. So this says that when a user is saved, then send this signal. And this signal is going to be received by this receiver. And this receiver is this create profile function. And this create profile function takes all of these arguments that our post save signal passed to it. And one of those is the instance of the user. And one of those is created. So we're saying if that user was created, then create a profile object with the user equal to the instance of the user that was created. I know that is a little confusing, but that's just how it's done in Django. So I hope that makes sense. Okay, and while we're at it, now that we have a create profile function that gets run every time a user gets created, let's also create a save profile function that just saves our profile every time the user object gets saved. And this is going to be almost identical. So I will just copy what we already have and paste underneath here. And I will call this save profile instead of create profile. And we don't need this created here, so we'll just remove that and keep the quargs on the end. If you don't know what quargs is, it just accepts any additional keyword arguments onto the end of the function. So now we don't need to check if this is created. All we want to do is save the profile when the user is saved. So we'll say instance, which is going to be the user, instance.profile.save. Okay, so that is going to do it for our signals. Now there's still one little small step that we have to do before this will work. So we have to import our signals inside of the ready function of our users apps.py file. So let's go inside of our users app, and in the apps.py module that we've seen already, within our users config here, we are going to create a function or a method in here called ready. And that is going to take self as the first argument. And within this ready method, we are just going to import those signals. So we'll say import users.signals. And like I was saying before, the Django documentation just recommends doing it this way to avoid some side effects of how imports work. So that is why we are doing it this way. Okay, so now let's save all of our changes and see if this worked. Now, this is kind of a longer process and it's easy to miss stuff as you're following along. So if it doesn't work for you for any reason, then you might just want to see if you missed anything in this process. So now let's pull up our browser and create a new user. So first, let me make sure that the dev server is still running, and it is. So now let's create a new user. So I'm going to log out and go to register. And now let's do new user 3, I think is what we're on now. We'll, for an email, we'll say nu3@company.com. And then we'll set a password of testing321 and sign up. Okay, so now we have created that account, and it tells us that it's created and that we can now log in. So now let's log in with that account and see if we have a profile page. So I'll say new user 3, testing321, and go to the profile page. All right, and we can see that this user does have a profile because they have a profile picture. Okay, so that's great. So that means that it just created that profile for us using our signals. And that's a lot better than needing to go in through the admin page and doing that manually every time a new user is created. That would be a nightmare to have to do that every time. Okay, so this looks good and is starting to come together. Now, I think that is going to do it for this video. Hopefully now you have a pretty good idea for how you can extend the user model in order to add more fields for our users. And also, I hope you understood the concept of using signals to perform certain actions when those signals are triggered. In this case, it was automatically creating a user profile after a user has been created. Now, in the next video, we're going to be finishing up our profile page and adding in the ability for users to update their information on the front end of the website. So they'll be able to change their username, their email, and also upload a new profile picture. And we'll also learn how to save space on our web server by automatically resizing images when they're uploaded. But if anyone has any questions about what we covered in this video, then feel free to ask in the comment section below and I'll do my best to answer those. And if you enjoy these tutorials and would like to support them, then there are several ways you can do that. The easiest way is to simply like the video and give it a thumbs up. And also, it's a huge help to share these videos with anyone who you think would find them useful. And if you have the means, you can contribute through Patreon, and there's a link to that page in the description section below. Be sure to subscribe for future videos, and thank you all for watching.